back to another ChevSpeaks video. In today's video, we'll be discussing all of the cool and interesting quirks of this 2003 Mercedes S55 AMG right behind me, and stuff that's just kind of weird about the car and just design elements that I'm not sure why Mercedes decided to implement them, but they did. So without further ado, here's the video. First thing we're gonna do, starting off, the soft closed doors. I think this is a really cool feature. It's common in very many luxury cars, but then again, this is an older car, so like you just close the door softly, and it kind of just hugs itself in. I don't know, I find that really cool, and it's definitely really helpful because you know how sometimes if you don't close your door, you'll have to like hit up against it. But in this, you will never have to do that because it's just like a little motor and it hugs the door. So that's my first cool feature about this. Second, it locked. Perfect. Oh, it unlocked. Okay. That's weird. Second cool feature of this car. So what I find really cool is this button right here. Now, let me start the car real quick. Now, about to press this button right here. Watch the back window. It's a power sunshade. I don't know about you guys, but I think that's really cool. And I've never really used it. There's never really been a purpose for me to use it. I just think it's so cool that it's there. Then again, this was a very expensive car when new. Depreciation has taken its toll on it, so a lot of these features were the highest luxury at the time. But now, I mean, you can find this in many other cars. So another thing that I want to show you guys. So imagine if you have backseat occupants and they want to raise their little headrest right here. And this one's not staying up, I'm not sure why. Okay, now it's staying up. Okay. So you're the driver, right? And you want to look out your back window, but you can't really see anything. Well, you see, instead of having to go back there and lower all those, there's this one little button right here that if you press it, they all just fall back. Again, one of those really extra features, but Mercedes decided to include it, and I find it really cool. Now, if you decide to take a look around the car, you'll notice there really aren't any cup holders. And for such a large car, I mean, there are cup holders right here, but that's standard on very many cars. But there aren't all too many cup holders in the car for the driver and the passenger. So you may think, well, where are these cup holders? Well, there's actually one cup holder in the car, and I think it's the coolest cup holder I've ever seen in my whole life. Here it is. It's hidden under here, and you press this, and it flings out. I think that's the most extra way that you could conceal and reveal a cup holder ever in a car. And by the way, this is the only cup holder in the front, in the front passenger area. So I'm not sure why for such a big car there was only one cup holder, but at least it's a really, really, really cool cup holder. Stepping outside of the car for this little quirk, I think this is a really cool feature. Again, this, when it was new, was a, oh wow, an acorn just fell in my car, perfect. When this was new, this was a very expensive car. So it has very, very nice features for its time. Even very nice features for today. This car has massaging seats. I'm not fibbing you. They're massaging seats. Here are the controls for it right here. This pulse setting right here, you can hear, I'm not sure if you can hear it, but some things start adjusting inside the seats, and little air bladders fill up over here, and they come out and then go back in, come out, go back in. Also, there's contour settings on the seat where if you move this button in or out, it adjusts the bolsters on the side of the seat. These are all like little air bladders that inflate and deflate with air to give you either a very wide seat for comfortable touring, or if you want to go on some turns and you want it to be a tighter seat, then you can just inflate those air bladders, and it keeps you in place very, very well. Also, there's these cool things called dynamic seats. Oh, it's moving up and down again. I'm not sure what it's doing. But anyways, there's these cool things called dynamic seats, where if you activate it, and whenever you start taking turns, for example, if you take a turn to the left, the air bladder on the right will inflate so that it keeps you in place. But whenever you're driving straight ahead, both air bladders will kind of deflate, so it's very comfortable. But you have to make a turn, quick turn, this air bladder will inflate, or this air bladder, depending on which way you turn, it'll inflate, and it'll actually create kind of like a bucket seat kind of feel, which is really, really, really neat. So this right here is also another really cool feature of the car. You see these little cutouts right here? Well, you may think that's just some, I don't know, some panel fitment issue or something like that, but it's actually something really, really, really cool. And I'll show you a video right now. I'm about to press this button.
See, well, you can see them right there.
They're little headlight washers. And that's just that German engineering thing. I don't know, it's crazy that they thought of it. So another very cool feature, I know I've said another very cool feature thousands of times, but this is really an interesting feature, is the center console. So as you can tell right here, you have your normal center console, but you have two little buttons right here, one and one right here. So if you press the one that's more towards the middle, if you press the one that's close to the middle, it normally opens up and you have your normal center console. Now if you press the one that's closer towards the driver, this little center console area opens up right here. You can store smaller things such as change. But the cool thing is under this one, this is a car phone. Nothing screams 2003 more than this car phone. Now, it's really cool, but I don't believe I'll be ever using it. The previous owner did tell us that it is possible to use it. I just messed up my glove box closing scenario. However, I really don't have any interest in using it, and I don't really see a purpose in it, but still pretty cool. So for this one, I'm actually in the garage. I had the car outside, I just drove it in. This one's a really interesting feature that I'm not sure if it's some just error that Mercedes decided to do. I'm not sure for what reason they decided to do it. But as you can see right here, my car's off, the car's off. Off, nothing's on. And I have two like 12 volt little cigarette lighter things I can plug in car chargers. One of them, the car's off, but as you can see, the light is shining and it's on. However, this one right here, the light is off. This, I mean, both of these, whenever the car is on, they're working, but I wonder why they made that one down there on whenever the car is off, but this one right here, not. I don't know. I think I find that very, very interesting and a very quirky design element of this car. Now that I'm about to get out of the car, I just turned it off, I'm about to get out of the car, you can tell how committed Mercedes was to driver and passenger comfort by the way that the car just acts whenever you open the door. So here I am about to open the door right here. And I want you guys to pay attention to the steering wheel and to the seat. I'll try to get both in the same frame, but here we try, here we go. The seat slides backwards and the steering wheel rises up. I think that's super cool. And it makes getting in and out of this car very, very, very simple. However, before I end this video, I just want to say one thing. I don't want these videos to make me appear that I'm bragging or I'm being narcissistic or I'm self-centered just because I have this car. I really, really enjoy this car. I enjoy driving it. I have a lot of fun with it. And I just want to make videos about it. I don't want this video to seem like I'm boosting it like it's the best car in the world, because it has problems. I'm very, very thankful to my parents who bought this car for me. I'm not gonna hide it. I'm not gonna say, oh, I worked six jobs, I didn't get tired, Kevin Gates reference. I'm not gonna say any of that. I'm gonna say my parents bought this car for me. I'm very thankful for them, and I'm not going to flex and lie to y'all that I'm some person that I'm not. However, I will say, if you want to look up the value of this car, it's not really worth too much more than a three-year-old Camry. I mean, probably even less than that. This car is on 115,000 miles. It's an older car. And yes, while new it may have been over $100,000, the car now is roughly around $10,000. And I don't want it to seem like I think I'm some elitist person. So I don't want to end this video like this, but I just feel like it had to be said. Anyways, I hope you guys are having a great day, and I really would like to see you in the next video. Deuces.